Well, as we've just seen, it was a night of contrasting emotions for many of our MPs. And joining me now are returning Labor MPs Alpito William-Seal and Jenny Salisa, as well as new Labor List MP Dr. Anai Neruleavasa. From the National Party, we have Te Atatū candidate Alfred Ngaro. Good morning to you all. A night of contrasting emotions, wasn't it? I see some three very big grins here. And Alfred, firstly, start with you. How was last night for you?
Well, it was a great time to, first of all, give thanks. And we're really blessed. You know, it's one thing that we are fortunate as politicians is to have volunteers who are family, who are friends, who come along and offer their time, their energy, just to believe in the things that we're doing. So really last night it was about doing that and thanking them for all their energy and effort. Yeah.
Alpito, on this side of the on the fence, how are you guys feeling with last night's results? Did you guys predict a victory like that or no?
Well, look, in the back of your mind, you're always optimistic and confident, and you want to get the vote out as a strong turnout. But look, last night's result, I would use the word unprecedented. And look, for me, it's just talking to our team, we've just been really, really grateful. I mean, we're excited, but we're also grateful and mindful, as Alfred said. There's a lot of people that we need to thank, but we're also sad in many ways, because you do need Pacific peoples and other parties, particularly in the opposition. With Alfred and Agnes that were there, we've maintained a good working relationship throughout. So on the one hand, we're excited because we're increasing our numbers in the Labor caucus, biggest Pacific caucus ever. But on the other hand, there are others who may not be returning, and we're sad for that.
Dr. Anai, congratulations.
Thank you.
First time coming in, I mean, what was it like for you last night? Were you expecting to get in? I mean, were you watching the numbers? Were you glued to the edge of your seat?
Yeah, I was pretty nervous, excited at the same time. And yeah, pretty much all of my team were glued to the TV, and I'm just really happy with the turnout and the result.
Jenny, you've been here before. Last election you came in, you could almost say you've been around the blocks now. For the new people coming in, you bring in a lot of Pacific MPs. What's the messaging around them? I mean, how do you bring them in? Some of them have very, very green. What would you say to them having been in their shoes before?
You know, one of the things that our party has done is over the last few months, they've actually had a few sessions with people that we think are definitely coming in. It's really, really humbling to see that four of the electorate seats are actually Pacific people coming in. And so we look to the list. Of course, the results are still provisional, but it's really humbling just to see how many people right across New Zealand have actually voted progressive and voted for the leadership of the Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern. My message to my new colleagues coming in is, you know, this is really an exciting place to work. And in the Labor Party, there is so much work for us to do, and it's so good. There's six of us in there now. We're expecting four electorate seats to come through Pacific, and we'll look to see if there are any others coming through from the list as well. So it's really exciting for the Labor Party and Pacific people.
Yeah, Alfred, where did it go wrong for National? Do you think? I know it's early days yet, it's been less than 24 hours, but I guess you guys will have a big think about the party and where it's going. Does it need a change of tack? I mean, where to now from here, do you guys think?
Yeah, I mean, look, it's been a difficult year, and as Alpito said, unprecedented, because we've had COVID-19. I mean, the whole world has stopped. And so in a situation like that, the government, and you know, it was a team of 5 million, you know, initially when we had to stop, that's important. So really, that's really been top of mind, I think, for the whole country to get through. So it was always going to be difficult to get past that, because that's been the number one issue. Look, people I've spoken to in the community want to know two things. Number one, are their children going to be safe when they go to school? They're not going to catch any bugs. And number two, are they still going to have a job when they go to work? You know, and so when you've got those two issues at play, COVID-19 was always going to be difficult. But, you know, at the end of the day, the government has won, the Labor Party, so I want to congratulate them. You know, that's what we do. Politics is a tough game. But at the same time, too, you have to give honour and acknowledgement where acknowledgement is due. And so, you know, I do wish them well in the roles that they have.
Yeah. Now, I understand we have on Zoom in Palmerston North is new Green Party MP Teanau Tuiono. Talo for lover. Brother, kia ora, how are you? As I fix my earpiece here to make sure I can hear you. But firstly, just tell us, what was last night like? How are you feeling? What time did you get to bed? Talk us through last night and how you came to be a new Green MP.
Yeah, no, we had a big night here in Palmerston North. I was just spending time with my campaign team and my whānau, my family as well, and just sort of really acknowledging the work that they've put in, all our volunteers, my campaign managers, the strong family support that I have. And so I wasn't really watching the numbers, but somebody would just kind of yell them out from the corner of the room, and I was like, oh, well, actually, that sounds pretty good. So I knew around about 6% I was getting in, and then when the numbers were higher than that, I was like, oh, okay, well, this looks like it's going to happen. Big night and a happy night.
Yeah. I mean, what are your plans that you want to do when you get in there? I mean, have you got sort of an inkling of what you want to sort of achieve or do? Or, I mean, talk us through the next steps that you're going to take now that you're going to be sworn into Parliament soon, no doubt.
Well, I'm interested in a whole lot of issues. So I've worked in education for over 20 years, so of course that's like top of the list for me. And I think having Pasifika representation in the Greens is really, really important, because as we know, Pasifika peoples are on the front lines of climate change, and we have been the political party that have been pushing for climate action for a very, very long time. And making those connections with what happens back in the home islands and how that connects with us here in Aotearoa New Zealand as well. So I want to do a bit of everything, to be honest. A little bit of social justice stuff, but also do some environmental stuff. And yeah, just, you know, looking forward to getting into it.
Oh, it's awesome, Matt. And congratulations on the win. No doubt it's going to be a busy next 3 years for you, and hopefully we'll get you in studio sometime to talk about yourself and the Green Party and what you guys hope to achieve in the next 3 years. So have fun down there, stay warm, and we'll see you at the Beehive sometime.
Yeah.
Awesome. Alfred, when you look at that and you see a new MP coming in, you've got a new MP next to you, does it take you back to when you first came into Parliament, that sort of fresh blood coming through and the excitement that sort of surrounds that when you do first enter politics?
Yeah, it does, and I think the thing that we can be proud of as a community is that we are getting more Pacific representation.
Yeah. Another Cook Islander in there, eh?
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
got to be good, eh?
Yeah, there was a time there where we've had not many at all, and so it was a proud day to become the first. But now we've got a number that are coming, and I think all of us agree, and Aupito, you know, acknowledge that he's been here for a time that's become the senior, really, of our Pacific MPs, and to see more representation, you know, is important. The challenge now is to be able to, as Jenny has said, you know, what is it that we do with that representation? And the other day, it was a proud time to see Panina Health, you know, step up as a community housing provider, and just to be able to celebrate. That's the sort of success we want to see more of our Pacifica people in the areas of commerce, more in the areas of development, you know, really leading the charge for our people.
Mm. Aupito, I just picked up on word that Alfred said senior.
Yeah. Hey, stop that.
Respectful.
And when I think of the word senior, I think, yeah, that's right. You know, you've been in the game for a while, you've held that Māngere seat for a while, or Labour's held it for forever. Is there now, you've got the mandate, pressure to deliver in the next 3 years? No excuses. You've got 3 years, a clear run, no real strong opposition. Mm. What will you do with it?
Well, look, I think we started fantastic work in the last 3 years, and that's laying strong foundations for the Pacific community. We're taking the community with us, understanding that our people are confident, they're thriving and resilient, and they want to be prosperous Pacific peoples. The young people have been adamant that this is their home, and they want to be treated with respect, they want to give back to New Zealand. But we do have some significant challenges, and those challenges are in the area of housing, education, home ownership, growing the business sector, looking at STEM and growing that. We've started to lay those foundations for Budget 19 and Budget 2020. We've got strategies that Jenny's been leading in the health sector as well as the education sector. All of that takes time and investment. We've got some new blood coming through. We're expecting that they contribute to that work. We've locked in money for the next 4 or 5 years.
And I have to politely stop you there, because we're going to go to an ad break. Okay. Someone's got to pay for this broadcast. Right. So, hey, look, well, when we come back, more from our Pacific MPs. We'll continue this telenor, so stay tuned. Don't go anywhere.